Hi, this is Laurel with an idea of how you can use your stockpile for Christmas gift baskets. And so let's take a look at these gift ideas that I have put here in front of you. And I have to say before I get started that I first saw a gift basket idea by Young Extreme Couponer, and she uses, I think she found some clearance hat boxes that she used to pack her gift baskets, and then Saving with Betta had some baskets that she was using. I think Pinching Pennies 2011 was using the gift bag idea. And those are just the three that I remember seeing. I'm sure that there are lots more I'm missing or haven't seen yet. So I guess let's start with this one. This is kind of the big one. This is, as you can see, you know, the throw, the $1.49 throw and pillow set is back there in the back, kind of as the background. When you make a gift basket, you need something tall and reasonably sturdy in the back, and then you will graduate down in height as you progress towards the front of the basket. And same with what's on the outside, the exterior of the basket here. As you're moving in, you are usually you're going down in height, but really the main rule of thumb is whatever's in the back needs to be the tallest. So this basket, I think, was either free or overage, all total. There's a bottle of Listerine back there. I got overage with that. The Cover Girl was free. The Revlon got overage. Skintimate, I think, was free. Crest toothpaste got overage. John Frieda got overage. Oral-B free. Band-Aid and First Aid Kit free, maybe a quarter each. The St. Ives, a quarter. Suave was free. Baby Lips was free. Razors got overage. The body wash got that was free. The toothbrushes got, they were free. So as you can see, I paid nothing, I think, for this basket all told. The overage from some paid for the quarter here and quarter there for the other items. And this is I think a nice gift basket for a woman. Excuse me, because, you know, obviously you can see that this gift basket is female oriented. You can obviously easily change this out, change that Nivea for her, make it a Nivea for him, the deodorant, make it deodorant for him, take out the baby lips, just put in maybe a Nivea instead. The nail tools, you might or might not want to leave those in. You know, men do need to clip their nails too, so you know, that's kind of that's a debatable, and you know, men need to shampoo and condition their hair, so, and then, you know, just add a men's shaving cream. So this is adaptable for men. And if you notice, I'm kind of big on themes and, you know, what might work best in terms of a theme. So let's say that you don't want to be real personal per se with the gift basket that you give. Well, here's a good food gift basket idea. This was a dollar at the dollar store, that little red bin there. And, you know, once again, the food in this was either free or maybe I may have paid as much as $4, maybe $5 for all the stuff in this. But, you know, again, this is herbal tea, this is jelly, this is a drink pouch, Starbucks. Now, I actually have a local source. I was able to get mine for $2.99 a bag, cheaper even than that Target deal that we saw last week. The pancake mix was free. The organic salad dressing was free. The potatoes were free. The cereal was free. So I think that this is a great impersonal gift basket, if you will. You know, not everybody you know well enough to give them, you know, shaving cream and deodorant and things like that. And this is also a great impersonal gift or a great housewarming gift. There is Bounce back here. There's Tide. I think the Bounce was 18 cents. Tide was free or overage. The Dawn was free. Cascade was free. Renews It was free. Glade was free. And I just used a canister that I still had from my Costco days. We just finished that up. And the canister makes a great gift container for this. So that was a really cool deal. And now I know that some of us don't have local family or gifts, you know, that people that we're sending gifts to. because none of our family lives close enough to actually hand them a basket. So, you know, there are a couple of mailing ideas that I put on the table as well. This is a small flat rate priority box. You can fill it with personal items. This one is filled with, as you can see, kind of hand and nail care items, emery boards, a brush, clippers, a little trial size lotion, nail polish. This was all free, if not, you know, overage. And, you know, it doesn't matter how heavy the stuff is in the box, because a flat rate priority box, it ships for the same price, regardless of destination or weight. Now, these are extremely lightweight. This is a great gift for the young man, and you know, that you need to give something to, late teens, early 20s maybe. And these razors were free to me, plus overage. And remember, these are the ones with the gift card, so you didn't pay anything for it, but he's gonna be thrilled, because this is, if he walked into the store to buy it, easily $30 to get the gift card for the iTunes and the razors. And as I said, they're really, really lightweight. You can even ship them in a package or an envelope, because they're not going to cost you a lot wherever you send them. It's going to be, I'm guesstimating, less than $4. So I do hope that you were able to get some inspiration from these baskets. I think they were really, really cute ideas, and you know, ways to very affordably gift those, you know, in your life, to give gifts to the people in your life that you want to acknowledge. If you've got like a teacher, I don't have a teacher themed basket in front of me, but you know, you can easily accomplish the same thing. You know, dollar bin, fill it up with paper and hand sanitizer and pens and school theme items. You know, it'd be great for a bin that size. And you know, just some very general ideas like that. And let's see. Oh, and you want to make sure that you're stuffing the bottom of these, because you need to elevate the items to kind of hang halfway, you know, kind of be raised up out of the basket or the bin that you might be using. So just an idea. You are welcome to leave me a comment below. You can leave questions in the comments below. Link a video response. I'd love to see what you did with your gift basket idea for Christmas. Don't forget to like if you like it. And if you are not a subscriber, I'd love to have you join me. Okay, thanks for watching.